we need first, next optical methods is turbidimetry. So turbidimetry, first term turbid. Turbidity is the cloudiness or haziness of the fluid. So there are, we see the clear water sample and some sample are cloudy in nature. That is the turbidity. So in measure the this turbidity by the instrument known as turbidimetry. When a incident light or when a light is incident or allowed to pass to a sample, there are three phenomena occurs. When a light is passed to the solution, three phenomena occurs. First, a light absorption take place. Second, light reflection or scatteration take place, and transmittance take place. So when the light are reflect or scattered, so we see the nephelometry. But here in turbidimetry, the sample size is large, or the particle size in the liquid, these are the high dimension than incident light. So the this light does not scattered. These light are absorbed by these high dimension particle. Turbidimetry is like the colorimetry. So if a beam of light is passed through this turbid sample, the intensity is reduced. So here we got the reduced intensity. Or decrease the intensity of transmittance light. So this decrease intensity is measures which is equal to the concentration of that turbid solution. So decrease intensity is directly proportional to turbidity of the substances. So like colorimetry, the measurement of light is at 180 degree. So here we see there are three phenomena. First, spectrophotometry, second, turbidimetry, and third, nephelometry. In spectrophotometry, there is a clear solution. Here, the clear solution, we measure the transmittance light. But in turbidimetry, the solution is suspended solution, or the particles are large particle. So we measure the transmittance light. And nephelometry, the suspension is same turbid suspension, but here the high dimensions, when the high dimension particle is present in the solution, we use turbidimetry. When the low dimension particle present in the solution, that is the colloidal particles are low dimension, then we use the nephelometry. Nephelometry, the scattering is 90 degree. We measure the scattering. But in turbidimetry, we measure the absorbance. The general instruments are light source, detector, and cell. In turbidimetry, the light source are generally used mercury arc or a laser. Detector are, we use ordinary detector such as phototube cells and cell or cuvette. cuvette it is like the quartz cuvette, it is the cylindrical cell. So next point is the application. Turbidometry is mainly useful for inorganic analysis for determination of sulfate as a BaSO4, carbonates as a BaCO3, chloride AgCl, fluoride CaF2, and cyanide by AgCN. And also we determined the total sulfur in coke, coal, oil, rubber, plastics. Next applications of this turbidimetry is the organic analysis. Plenty of citrus juices. Another biochemical uses turbidimetry is measurement of the amount of bacterium in liquid nutrient medium. It is also useful to find out the amount of amino acid, vitamins and antibiotic. So in biochemical uses, we determine vitamins, antibiotics, and in bacterium also. So air and water pollution, continuously monitoring the air and water pollution, smoke or dust is monitored. Turbidometric is also useful for the turbidimetric titration. And also we determine the molecular weight of high polymer. So generally the turbidometrics are light source, lens, sample or cuvette, second lens and detector. So this is all about turbidimetry.